Yeah.
And? Did we, is this new? Do we not know? Also, Elton John. I don't know if that's a new one, too.
So here was the funny part, is I was like, oh yeah, you know, Boy George, you know, he just came out too, right? And she made some comment about how he just got secretly married in 2015. I was like, wait, no, Boy George is definitely out. And she's like, oh no, I'm still talking about Barry Manilow.
Barry Manilow. Like, oh yeah.
You guys hear me?
Hi, Dave. Yeah, we're talking about famous gays. Welcome to the show, Dave.
Can you hear me? Oh, okay. Because I don't have my mic. I just have my earbuds in.
Where's your mic?
I haven't got it yet because I was trying out Battlefield 2042 on my laptop. And then...
Got it yet?
Like, is it's in the other mail? Room. Oh, no, it's in the other room.
Go get it.
In the mail.
I will.
Go get it.
I wanted to answer, though. Because I was like... Oh. I'm like... So I was trying that Battlefield 2042 just because I can play it on my laptop.
Yeah.
And I'm like running around. And then all of a sudden, I just hear the Skype thing. And I'm like, what time is it? What day is it?
Right before that, Robbie said, does Dave know what day it is?
Never.
And Jake said, absolutely not.
Absolutely.
Okay. I'll go grab my mic.
All right.
You know what's great about this week of football?
What's that?
Either Oregon State or Washington have to lose.
One of them's losing. I have no feelings either way.
Like, either way, fuck them.
Yeah.
I got honestly. Way.
Why?
I would rather Washington lose just because it's fuck Washington him. More. It's one
if
of those.
They if they win, it helps if, us towards the playoffs.
That's true.
That's and Robin only... definitely hates the Beavers the same way I hate the Huskies.
Yeah.
It's like, it's pretty even.
They can fucking fuck off.
For real. Today we have the Angry Orchard Blueberry Rosé.
Oh, I thought it was a Bartles and James. I was like,
if I had a B&J, you know, I'd be sitting here with the fucking...
Are you doing stuff in the living room? Oh, I thought you were working.
Yeah, I'd be doing stuff in the living room with the Bartles and James.
God damn it.
I'm off the bus with the Bartles and James.
Yeah, son. Oof, the Lakers are getting smacked. 37-19. El Kingos.
Los Reyes.
Yeah, sure.
El Kingos. Let's see. I would love to have somebody be part one half of the duet in The Golden Rule by The Lonely Island for karaoke.
I don't know that song, I don't think. I might, actually. Now that I say it.
Here, I'll play it.
Dave's House.
Welcome to Dave's House, where we will...
Welcome to Dave's House. Something, bunch of words.
Bunch of cunts here.
He does live in the country.
There's, yeah, we live in the country. I wonder, like, I want to make a country song, and just every time I say country, just like really emphasize cunt, then like see if I could get away with it.
Oh, you definitely could. It'd be just a Wheeler Walker type song.
Wheeler Walker Jr. Yeah, good old Wheeler.
Or the Dick Down in Dallas dude. What was his name? Trey. What was his name?
I don't remember. What was
Trey Lance? I don't know. Country.
Oh, for that. It was a song of some sort that you hadn't heard.
Never suck.
Yeah, fuck.
Oh yeah, Lonely at Island.
Oh yeah. We already got Universal on our ass, so this will be fine.
Trey Lewis, that's his name. Wait, why is Universal on our ass?
We played Saturday Night Live clips on the show.
Oh yeah.
So you'll have to edit
it
this.
Will. Maybe.
Let's see. Share screen. Add computer sound. The Rone Re-Ironed. All right, here we go.
Is it banana and jackfruit?
Yeah.
Nice. Allow ads, I guess. Like, if I allow ads, will you... Fine.
Oh, yeah, I know this song.
Well, now we have to live with it. I feel like me and Dave rock this.
Yeah. Oh God. Susan Sarandon.
Yeah. Oh, I forgot. I got my speakers on, so I'm gonna let it bump.
Your mom says hi. Jinx.
So I'm in the city and everybody's having sex.
Yes, that'd be awesome.
Shoe sores. I also have a cutie to call who loves the way I knock on her boots.
Well, it's time to Mac. Let's handle that. In 2 to 6 hours, we'll meet back then. We're going to our last show.
Roll up to her crib with some Bartles and James.
I'm off the bus to the Alizé.
Now hold up, player, what you diggity doing here?
I should diggity ask you the same.
Yes, you say.
Boys, I want you both.
Look at Lady Gaga. So fucking
funny. Easily.
I'll co-sign that. Hard agree.
I don't get down with dudes.
But tonight is a special exception, queen.
See, you're my best friend, too thick and thin.
Now it's time to make a triple connection.
It's off. Here in the dark.
Here in the dark.
It's hard to tell.
So hard to tell.
Where her body ends.
La, la.
And my homies begins. This rule dates back.
The golden rule.
To ancient Greece.
I hate to say it.
With two jack trippers and a Chrissy. The three's
company. Yeah. Where's Jessica when you need her?
You guys are still here.
It's okay. It's in a three-way. It's not gay. It's in a three-way. With the honey in the middle, it's a leeway. The area's great. It's a 1, 2, 3-way.
Get ready. To impress a chick, helicopter dick, go helicopter dick, helicopter dick.
All right.
To impress a chick, do the helicopter dick.
Wow.
And all of that was okay. It's
because she looks like a trashy, like 80s woman. That's why she looks hot. I mean, I'm not saying it's a bad thing. I'm just saying that's why.
The old devil's threesome.
The old DT, DPDT.
I got a new snack, boys.
Oh, the DDT?
No, it is a banana and jackfruit lumpia.
Less excited, but still excited.
Oh. I want one. Normally, I don't get down with dudes. But tonight is a special exception. Tonight we make a triple connection.
Yeah.
Fellas.
What do we have to talk about?
So much to talk about.
We got some things.
We got some things to talk about. We got old Cuntzilla to talk about.
Oh my God. Are we showing that video?
May as well.
It can't get taken down because it's not copyrighted.
Yeah.
So, here, let me send you mine.
You have a video of this hoe bag?
Yeah. Because she was such a hoe bag, I was like, well, I'm just going to record her and pretend I'm not recording her. Because, like, I have a picture of her. Get out of there, light. There we go.
Yeah, I remember that.
Sitting there, not cheering for anybody. It was weird. I should have known something was off when I realized this chick hasn't stood up and cheered for either team. She's wearing neutral colors like she's a returning ex-player. What is wrong with her? Oh, I see. I see. That's what's wrong with her.
And I realized that the way they told me I was ruining their enjoyment of the game. And the way I did that was being on the rail and yelling at USC where they could not.
Yeah.
That guy was eye banging me from the fucking jump.
I think, well, because we had like six people there, but like,
well, we normally have like six people there.
Yeah, and it's usually not a problem. But like, I was recording Shout, and I'm like, right in the middle of Shout, I'm like, how are you not going to be excited and happy about Shout?
Right.
She's just sitting there like,
I just like Lincoln. It's like, imagine flying from Las Vegas to Eugene, buying tickets just to scream Boomer Sooner at Lincoln Riley.
Yeah. So here's what I imagine happened was he wanted to go to the game because he was wearing duck gear.
No, he was wearing one piece of duck gear that he very clearly bought that day.
It was Walmart duck gear. Well, he had a hat and a jacket. He had like the black and gray.
I didn't see the jacket. I only saw the hat.
Because it was black and gray. It had the same duck that your shirt has.
Yeah. Okay.
And the way I see it going down was though he was like, hey, I want to go to this game. And she's like, no, absolutely not. And he's like, well, I'll get two tickets and you can yell at Lincoln Riley. All right, fine. She holds his balls.
Clearly. That seems like such a weird, like, I don't know, man. We've been scorned by a couple coaches recently, and like, at no point did I ever think that I should fly to like Virginia to yell at fucking Mario Cristobal while he plays the Volunteers or the fucking Cavaliers.
I didn't even yell at Chip when he came back.
Yeah, it's like, cool, man.
If anybody, like, I can't see Oklahoma feeling any worse than what we had with Chip, because Chip took us to places we had never even seen as a team.
Right. And Lincoln Riley is just like the first in a long line of coaches to lead Oklahoma to the promised land and then not win.
Right. So it seems weird.
Hey, look at over here.
Hey, yeah.
And
there
it is.
Yeah.
Did you see that it was autographed, Dave?
I did not see that.
It's hard to see from there, but you can kind of see it.
You see there's a scribble.
Tell me where's the scribble at?
Left side.
Right on the 8?
Yep, can't see it. Oh, yep, can't see it. My eyes don't work too good. Is that old Bill Shakespeare?
Yep. And then I got the old boobly heads over here. And I've got the old podcast over here. Hey, it's Austin.
Hey.
Hey.
I like that you have your own room.
Basically.
You're like, this is my room now.
Well, this wasn't big enough for both kids. And so we moved them out into what used to be the living room. And now I have this area.
Yep. That's fair.
I mean, I fall asleep in here a lot too, so it's basically like it's kind of like. Yeah. I mean, taking it back to the old days where husbands and wives had their own separate bedrooms and shit.
Yeah.
It's your study.
It is my study. I study porn and shit.
Video games.
It's your home orifice.
My horfice.
Horcrux. Don't destroy it.
In my notes, I wrote, I wrote Karen of Oklahoma.
That's accurate.
Mm-hmm.
Fucking
I'm gonna turn the light on in this room. Looks a little. What happened? I do this.
Yeah, so I watched the recording from last week, and I had dimmed my lights because it was bothering me, and then I was like, "Oh, you can't see me."
Mm. I should. You're fucking John Cena. I should probably flip on that light too, so I have a little foreground light. I don't have this weird shadow on my face.
Hey.
Yeah, that was Black off, Dave. Dave. That's the opposite.
Black Dave. Shit. Oh, it's the Undertaker. And look behind him. This is where the Undertaker pops up behind Dave.
What?
Huh? Hey, you lost your mic, I think.
There we go. Now we're back.
Glad we're back. Good morning.
We'll use the.
In the golden moon. Right, Dave, we get it.
Turn around.
Dave, did you post that picture for work?
Oh, no, I didn't.
Of course you did.
Turn around, bright eyes. Every now and then I take a shit.
What?
Wait, what?
Huh?
Am I hearing it wrong?
Maybe.
All right, let's get that nice and tight. Get it in tight like a toiger.
Oh yeah, I did watch that at Madam Web trailer.
Dude.
The only thing I know about Madam Web is she's old.
Yeah.
And so I was like, it did nothing for me. And then I saw different Spider-Mans.
Yeah.
And I know that I just don't know that much about the Madam Web storyline.
Right. Jake and I were kind of on the same page as you. Mm-hmm. Like, we've seen her from the cartoon briefly. Yeah.
And she just sits in her chair that's got a giant web behind her. And I always I don't even remember a whole lot about it. I thought it was like a time travel thing. Madam Web was a time travel thing too. But
yeah.
But I those are just guesses at this point because I really don't know that much.
And who is this bad guy Spider-Man? There's bad guy Spider-Man?
Mm-hmm. Evil Spider. Oh.
It's
Miter San.
Well, see, that one threw me off because DC made a knockoff bad guy Spider-Man too.
Did they?
And so, yeah. And I was just like,
I don't remember that.
I don't, yeah. He's very, really, really small time DC villain. Like, it was almost like they made him just to make him so that people would be like, hey, that's Spider-Man. And then they stopped making him. Like, they intentionally were just like, hey, remember that time you guys did that thing with the whole Wade Wilson thing?
Yeah.
Well, now we made a Dieter Darker.
Yeah, how do you like Dieter Darker?
Dieter Darker.
Dieter Darker.
Dieter Darker is the name of the pre-show.
Right.
Have you guys watched the Across the Spider-Verse?
No, my kid was just watching it. It's on my list. Loves
both the movies so far, and I've started them, and I can't. I don't like the animation style, and so
I watched it when I was on mushrooms.
Yeah,
that would probably do that.
So I watched Into the Spider-Verse, which was the first one.
Yeah,
and it was a while back, right? Like when it first came out, I watched it, and then I'm like, you know what? I've got this new thing on my TV that I can watch just about anything. I'm like, I'm gonna look for Into the Spider-Verse. Thinking I'm looking for Across the Spider-Verse.
Yeah.
And I sit there and I watch the first like 30 or 40 minutes of Into the Spider-Verse. And I'm like, wait, is this like a multiverse thing where they're showing the original story, but there's going to be changes? And I'm like, I'm so confused. And then it just kept going. And I'm like, wait, they're raiding the same facility. Like, this is a long time for them to be like drawing out this, like, it's the same story, but it's different.
Yeah.
And so I get on my phone and I'm like, looked it up. I'm like, is there supposed to be like a time shift thing? And I'm like, I'm watching the wrong damn movie for 40 minutes.
I can't tell you how many times I've subjected Jen to basically the same behavior, but with TV shows where if we're like, all right, let's get to season two of this and I'll put on episode one and I'll be certain that it's just a recap of what happened in season one. And no, it's not. It's episode one of season one. And we watched 11 minutes of it.
This is a very in-depth recap. It's like scene for scene.
Did you finish the movie, though?
I did end up finishing. And it was one of those things where I started the movie thinking, all right, I'm going to watch this. Do not come. I was like, I'm going to watch this because at the end of it, it'll be a good time for me to go to sleep. But then I wasted 40 minutes, and I was like, do I really want to stay up later than I want? Ah, fuck it. So yeah, I watched it. It was pretty good. I enjoyed it. I really enjoyed the Bollywood.
Dieter Darker.
Dieter Darker. Mm-hmm. I can't remember his name, but the Indian Spider-Man. Yeah, I thought he was hilarious. Mm.
Dieter Darker.
I'm going to look up his name because it was like a Peter Parker, but they Bollywooded it up.
His name is Patel Parker.
Patel Parker.
Oh, man. My friend, I will give you good deal.
Did you guys watch that The Killer on Netflix yet?
Not the yet. What? I just added it.
I keep seeing ads for it every 2 seconds.
Yeah. Oh, okay. So the Indian Peter Parker is Pavitir Prabarker.
Pavitir Prabarker.
Yeah.
Perfect.
I'm like, yep, that checks out.
The Punjabi Spider-Man, Pavitir Prabarker. Mm-hmm.
The Killer is
fucking canceled.
Michael Fassbender, maybe.
Oh, I heard about that.
He's not slow.
I want to see Michael Slowbender.
Yep. Yeah. It's
if you watch Avatar, you might be able to see Michael Airbender.
Hey.
It's interesting. It's not like the greatest movie. It's a good one if you're just watching, looking for something to watch.
Mm-hmm. Now, it also was like they came out with that movie and Netflix is like, hey, let's get some rights for some Michael Fassbender movies. Because on my just added, there was Killer. And then I scrolled down and then like Prometheus was on there. And then there's some other Michael, like two or three more Michael Fassbender movies. And I was like, yeah, they're just like.
Well, they see that other movie, First Goal Wins or Next Goal Wins or whatever it is.
Mm-hmm.
Like they see that's coming out and they're like, oh, he's gonna get advertising, people are gonna look for movies with him, let's drop our own and get all these other ones.
It's smart, especially when you consider the writer strike just ended and people are going to be consuming all sorts of new media.
We could talk about the Marvels if we want to. I don't have it. It's again. Well, I mean, it's obviously because it just came out this weekend.
I wouldn't be surprised if you had already seen it.
I did. I watched it Monday.
Then there you go.
Because I didn't have anything to do, and I was sick. But I was like, I feel good enough to go watch this movie, and I went. And then the next day, I was fucking just exhausted and
dead.
Way worse. I was like, that was a terrible idea.
Still like the movie. Bad choice.
Right? Milk was a bad choice.
It was the milk was a bad choice of movies.
Yeah. Oh, speaking of milk is a bad choice, I'm pretty sure I'm lactose intolerant now.
Oh, awesome.
Well done.
Because I had milk and cookies, and I can't remember the last time I had milk and cookies, mostly because I try not to have those because I will eat all of the cookies.
All of them.
So I had like one cup of milk and like three or four cookies, and then all night long, I was either shitting
all
or farting.
Doo-doo.
Like, I was like, oh, I think I'm lactose intolerant now. And my dad's like, that's not the usual milk we buy. That's definitely got a bunch of lactose in it. Because apparently a lot of Umpqua dairy milk, they take all the lactose out.
Mm. Interesting.
So you've conditioned yourself to a lactose-free environment.
That could be it.
Yeah. Whereas I've been drinking whole milk. I'm
all
lactose.
The time.
Like I am super tolerant of lactose, whereas you won't stand for it.
In fact, you've been sitting all night.
You just won't.
Well, like I was working on, I was working on schoolwork. I'm sitting on the computer, and like every like 5 minutes, it was like a long rip. Just brrr. I'm like, I did not eat beans today or yesterday. And then I'd rip a couple of them, and then the third one, I'll be like, oh no, I'm gonna shit myself.
Dude, I had Chipotle yesterday. I was so hungry, I went and got double meat Chipotle, and I had what I affectionately call cannonball farts. That's the only way to describe the way they feel coming out of my butt.
When it feels like a solid ball shooting.
Yeah,
out.
Just a big butt. Just like, oh.
I'm just picturing like the slow-mo video of a cannonball being fired out, but then like they overlapped your butt near it. And it's just like...
Instead of a cannonball, it's just a green ball of gas coming out.
I thought you were gonna say like a slow motion video of your butthole contracting and
Now I kind of want to see if that exists.
Oh, it exists.
Why do you know?
I scrolled through a few videos and I'm like, why am
I've been on the internet for like 20 years. You tell me I haven't seen a butthole farting.
I mean, I've been on there the same amount, probably more. And I once
watched a video where this girl got naked, sat on a cake and farted. And I was like, why did I watch the whole thing?
You're like, well, mostly what curiosity. Happened to the cake after?
Well, like, dude, the growth of internet has just killed innocence.
Did they light the 100%.
Candles? No, they did not.
So, I mean, the worst thing that happened to our society isn't so much the internet. It's the fact that we got rid of, like, our video or our photo, because our photo made you have to check your shame at the door to have fucking dirty photos of yourself and your significant other. Like, you had to go and look somebody in the eye and be like, yep, that's my buddy.
Oh, 1 hour photo. I was like, I was like, our photo. I'm like, what is our photo? What is there a picture of us that I don't know about? What is he talking? I was very confused.
There's a picture of us you don't know about. All of our buttholes.
All of our buttholes are exposed. But no, like, you would have to go and like the person would you know, do your photos, and then that you'd come back and pick them up, and they would look you in the eye and be like, they are.
That was only like a temporary thing, because before that they had you mailed them off. You'd go to like Bi-Mart or Payless or something like that. And
sometimes
and you had to write out a little envelope, and you'd send them off to a photo processor, and then you get your pictures back like a week or two later. So you don't know who's got your nudes. Yeah.
Then there's a bunch of 1990 Bushes just floating around out there at some dude's photo album.
You know it exists. Sure. You know that there was a guy who was working in a central lab somewhere that has this like photo collections of just naked chicks from around the world.
Well, did you guys watch the Winning Time, where Jerry Buss had he had an album of all the chicks he had slept with?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I saw that.
That was his album of naked chicks.
His scoreboard.
And now it all fits onto this.
Uh-huh. And yeah, like that's the thing. Like now everybody can just, you know, whip their dick out, take a picture, and send it to somebody directly to their phone. There's no shame in that whatsoever.
No,
I could send my dick to 1,000 people right now, and they would never know who I was.
Mm-hmm. Of course, you might get weird phone calls and texts.
Oh yeah, there are definitely consequences to sending my dick to 1,000 people, but you know, they wouldn't know who I was right away.
Yeah, that's fair.
All right, man.
These people.
Are you ready for Get Out Show?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Cool. All right, here we are. We're back again. It's another edition. It's another episode. And we're joined by one of the finest, one of the greatest, one of the latest to the game this week. It's Dave.
That is fair. Latest to the game. Most sober game I've had in years.
Doesn't this suck?
Actually, I enjoy it a little bit more. Like, I love drinking. We all know that. I like getting that drunk on. But when it comes to the game, I know what's going on. You know what I mean? Like, even drunk me, like, we'll be at the game and I'll cheer and I'll see, like, the big things. You see the big things and you're like, yeah! But as someone that loves football, I like being able to pick apart the little things, too. Mm-hmm. So, like, this game, I was like, I saw things and I was like, that's awesome. Like, you know, it wasn't just the big plays that I got hyped for. I was hyped the whole time. Because I knew what was going, you know, I always know what's going on, but you know what I mean. So yeah, it was great.
Unless you're high, then it's.
Yeah. That's the thing. If I'm high, this is me. If I'm drunk, this is me. And if I'm sober, this is
somewhere
me.
In the middle.
Yeah. And if you're crossfaded, it's.
Windmill.
A lot of dancing.
Yeah.
A lot of dancing this week.
Mm-hmm. But yeah, this thing, I was able to pound a few drinks real quick and get a super nice buzz going. And so I was right in that sweet zone of I'm having fun, but I know what's going on.
That's what happens when you don't have 6 hours to tailgate. You have 30 minutes.
Yep, exactly. But I'm not going to trade that. I'm not going to do that every time because I like my tailgating. Yeah. And speaking of tailgating, man that hooked me up with a beer bong as soon as I got there.
Yep.
I was introduced by the man that handed me an open beer, and now I'm introducing the man that cracks me up a long, thick beer bong. Robin?
You're goddamn right it is.
I'm Ron Burgundy.
It's Mr. fucking hand me a beer bong.
Big old thick one.
Oh, so glad I brought the beer bong back. Mm-hmm. I was like, brought you know what we need today? Beer bong back,
baby.
What do we need this week?
Beer bong. We need the beer bong.
Mostly because I was like, I was cleaning off the dryer, and I was like, hey, why is this not gone to the game yet? The beer bong was sitting there. So yeah, brought it in. Anyway,
did you guys do many beer bongs before I got there?
We did a few. We handed out some. I taught some people how to do them.
Everyone did a beer bong who was supposed to do a beer bong. Mm-hmm. Ben did a beer bong.
He did. Mm-hmm. Did showed him pretty, some things.
Did, yeah, it was good did times. Pretty admirably.
Yeah.
I got reacquainted to the beer bong, and yeah.
It all worked out. Mm-hmm. Bringing it back around. Full circle. The hoop snake, known as Jake.
It's me. It's one take, Jake. Back in the saddle again, and so we did 300 episodes. Here's to another 300. Not quite sure what the future holds exactly, but we'll see as things unfold. I like to keep it mysterious and fresh for you listener out there. We got quite a bit to get to, quite a bit to talk about, but I think we should start right there with Dave showing up. He gets there right about 6:15. Hand him a beer as he shows up.
Was it that late?
Like 6:15 to 6:25 was around there because I got stuck on Garden.
Harlow and Garden.
Yeah, Harlow and Garlow.
Mm. Jack Harlow and Garden.
Yep, Harlow and Garlow.
Harlow and Garlow is the name of this episode.
Write it down.
Write it down.
I got stuck there. And then I was also tailgating the crap out of this car. Because they thought they could squeeze in. And because I didn't want a dent in the front of my Jeep, I let them in.
You allowed them.
Yep. But then I risked the dent in the front of my Jeep by staying 3 feet behind them all the way down Garden Valley, all the way down Harlow, and all the way down Garden.
Gateway.
Yeah.
Gateway Harlow Garden.
Gateway Harlow Garden. I just rode them.
GHG.
Yep. The whole time, rolled my window down and stuck my head out the window as I drove behind him.
Like an Ace Ventura. Ace Ventura,
yeah. Which sucks. Move the sister.
Which sucks in the Jeep because you know how it sits, and I'm also short, so I'm like standing up, like standing on my pressure on my heels, so I can still throttle and brake. But I'm like, I'm too short, but I'm gonna do this.
It's like every time you see that little old lady driving whose eyes just barely make it over the steering wheel, like that was
that's me hanging out the window for some reason.
Dave's like trying to elevate the No Scrub song. He's like he's hanging out the side of his own ride.
No. I definitely got a taste of what it feels to be Robin driving to the game when we're running a little bit late. Because I was getting angry.
Mm-hmm.
One, nobody's fault, really. I had to work.
Yeah.
The way she goes.
But it was just like, as I'm watching the minutes tick, not really, I'm not looking at an analog clock, but you know what I'm saying. As I'm feeling the minutes tick away, I'm like, yo, I want to be there at 6 o'clock, not 6:10, not 6:15, 6 o'clock. And I'm like, all right, I'll be there at 6:15. Now it's 6:16 and I'm not there yet. Now I'm getting pissed.
That's exactly how I felt the week before on my way down to the Cal game, because like I was going through that exact same thing. I'm like bargaining with myself, like, and I'm also trying to allow myself to be okay with the possibility that I'm not going to make it.
Mm-hmm.
Because if I don't make it before the people thin out, I'm not getting in. I don't have a 10 minutes late is too late.
Mm-hmm.
So I've definitely got a deadline to make it there. And yeah, I know that exact feeling of anger of everyone around you and anxiety. Is like, none of you are in as big of a hurry as I am. Please get out of the way.
Right.
Like, even if we're going in the same direction, I guarantee you I will get there first.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you would be behind me. I would never be behind you.
Was kickoff at 7 or 7:30?
7:30.
So I got a good 45 minutes of hanging out.
7:30 was a saving grace, too.
So, yeah, we ended up parking over two rows from where we normally park because I was also late because I listened to my dad. I was like, hey, I want to leave at 11 so that in case something happens, I have time and I get there early. Because I was basically, usually he goes with me and Dave goes with me. Well, neither of them are going with me. So I'm making sure everything is basically remembered. And I have Riv with me, which is fine. And I left. I waited until 11:30 because he was like, we're going to meet at 12 because this was our night game where we decided to bring Chinese food. We did it last year. We did it the year before when we didn't have COVID. I think we did it before that. And so he's like, well, I'm going to be at the Chinese place at noon, blah, blah, blah. And I was like, I'm okay. Hurry, I guess. And it took like half an hour at the Chinese food place, so I didn't get left from there until like 12:35 in Roseburg, which is really only 20 minutes from my house, which means I have about an hour and 10 minutes to get to Eugene normally. So I'm already at least 5 minutes late when we leave at 12:30. No, 15 minutes late, and that ended up being what we were. It was 15 minutes late getting to park, and I was also pissed off the whole time.
Also, you made the handoff to get the chili before, so that added a couple minutes.
Right, which, whatever, took like literally 5 minutes at the most.
Mm-hmm.
But that was also planned. It's
and
not
I
like
was
I
already
said,
late. No, it wasn't a surprise.
It's also not like it's the last second. Hey, how about this?
Yeah, yeah. So I wasn't, mm-hmm. I was like, this is part of what we're doing, so. Which I still have some. I ate some yesterday.
Nice.
I'll probably have some tomorrow.
Some good shit.
Good chili.
Some good chili.
Yeah.
No, I was telling Ben on the way down, I said, you can tell how much I care about something by how many of my fingerprints are on the logistics of what's happening. He's like, what do you mean? I said, well, I have been very specific about when I'm picking everybody up, when I'm dropping the chili off. I'm like this, like the night game at Autzen is its own thing. It's its own experience.
Yeah.
And so like, yeah, there, I wasn't going to miss a freaking moment of what we were doing there that day. So like I had everything like triple checked, make sure that we're eyes are crossed and our T's are dotted.
Either way.
Dot the D.
Dot the D, baby.
Urethra.
Deeter darker.
Oh, shit.
Do we have they put said anything about what kickoff for Civil War is yet, or is that
still
waiting? Yeah,
they said it in August.
Did they? Well, what did they say?
5:30.
Okay.
Oof.
Yeah. Sweet.
5:30. So we're leaving at 11. I think 11. Maybe 10. Oh, 10. We're leaving at 10.
Yeah, because I was like, that's right. 11, wait, 11, 12, 30. Yeah.
We're leaving at 10. 10. I forgot.
Mm-hmm.
So okay. I'll pack everything the night before, and which means I get to go shopping on Wednesday because I'm not shopping for stuff on Thanksgiving. So we'll be ready to go.
Mm-hmm. So I got switched at work. So I've got that whole day. I've got all of that day off. So
good.
Don't have to do the rush.
So let's see, Jake and Ben and Bale showed up. We hung out for a while, got TV set up and all that stuff. And we went over to Jed's. Jed had ribs. And I was like, oh my God.
Whatever's fanciest, unless there's ribs.
Ate the shit out of some ribs. They had these, you know how Costco will do those giant cupcakes, but they're cake flavored or whatever?
Yeah.
They had an apple with a caramel top, caramel, or caramel
I missed
with
out
apple
on that.
Topping.
I forgot about that.
Me and Riv ate a whole one. like right there. we shared it. He's like, she's eating, and I'm like, hey, you've had enough of that. My turn.
Yeah, pass that on over here.
Yeah, I'm gonna need some of that. And then Jed had koozies for us, which was cool.
Yeah, and stickers.
Yep. Oh yeah, and the stickers too.
Yeah, I got one of the stickers.
We stopped by Jessica's tailgate there, and Riv sold Grayson's pepperoni sticks. You know how like Grayson was selling pepperoni sticks for $1.50. She was just selling them, and people were giving her extra money. She ended up selling them all for $36, which she was supposed to do, and then made an additional $36 for herself. So she literally doubled the sales.
Mm-hmm.
And so she was like, I'm buying this and this and that. I was like, I don't care. It's your money. You did it. That was cool.
Yeah, it was kind of fun too. Like I gave her a fucking little sales lesson there too.
Yeah.
Because she's walking out there and she's hitting him with the, hey, pepperoni sticks for sale. I'm like, man, you got to get a better hook than that. I was like, who gives a fuck about pepperoni sticks? Everybody's got food, but you got to give them a reason to care.
Right.
And she's like, what? I'm like, what are you selling them for? Like, well, you know, there's this field trip. I'm like, there we go. We're raising money for a field trip. That's how we open.
And which I don't even know that's why Grayson was selling him. I just, somebody asked and I was like, it's for a field trip. And they're like, to where? I was like, the science center.
Like fucking Washington, D.C., dude.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know where the field trip is, but they're selling them.
Mexico.
We should just buy a ton of those pepperoni sticks and then every game, like, raising money for my kids' field trip. They're going to like in the place.
They're going to Carcosia.
I'm selling these so my kid can go to Autzen.
Yeah.
My kid Autzen can go to Autzen.
But we all give them a different place that the field trip's going.
There you go.
The aquarium. Tampa. What?
It's Stonehenge.
Mm-hmm.
San Diego Zoo.
Big Ben.
Roethlisberger or the other place.
Yeah, the other place.
Stonehenge 2.
Electric Boogaloo.
Stone Boogaloo.
Carhenge, maybe.
Carhenge. There we go.
Yeah. They're going to the Bigfoot Festival.
I just say the Painted Hills, since there's like four different places in this country called the Painted Hills.
Coachella.
Coachella.
She asked what Coachella was the other day, and I was like, well, it's technically a place, but it's associated with a concert that, like, everybody in L.A. has to go to.
L.A. Have you been to Coachella out of L.A.?
Right.
There's a bit of... Go ahead. I was going to say, there's a bit of Migos lore about Coachella. Like, they apparently turned in a total dog shit performance. And, like, they've rapped about it in their since albums, kind of making fun of themselves for being bad at Coachella.
Oh.
Dig it.
He's like, he's like, I met this bitch at Coachella. It's like, it's kind of a little nod to, we know.
Mm-hmm. Did you hear about how bad Coachella was this year and everyone getting stranded out there? And it
no, raining. But it's hilarious. I love when people have a bad time.
That was Burning Man.
That's also the Fyre Burning Festival.
Man? Yeah, Burning Man was the one where they had a fucking monsoon and their whole desert thing turned into a mud thing.
The playa, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Dude, okay, Burning Man, Coachella, same thing to me.
They fucked up the playa, like, big time.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
they always do, though, because they leave so much garbage and waste and...
The amount of garbage was insane this year, right? Well, there were like trucks and stuff too, because they're like, oh, we can make it. No, we can't.
Stuck.
Oh, might we can make it? How are you, can? Talking about it.
Have you guys seen? There's this TikTok account called Game Changer.
Maybe.
I don't know why I haven't sent you any of it. It is hilarious. It's like a game show,
mm-hmm.
but it's like it's kind of like one of those things. It's the same people that do Funny or Die or something like that,
uh-huh.
and it's like a stand up thing. And they have three contestants and a guy running the show, and he'll just like he picks somebody or whoever's turn it is, and he's like Arnold Schwarzenegger ordering a pizza. in Germany, and someone has to pretend to be like do that.
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty funny.
It's like improv.
Yeah, like an improv game show thing.
Okay.
I'm gonna send it to you now that I'm thinking about it, because I never do think about it.
This is something we could. This is something we could watch right now.
Yeah. Well, while he's not showing this, let's continue talking about that duck game then, because that also ties into TikTok. Because this fucking bitch that was sitting next to me showed up on my For You page after she got Jake kicked us out of our seats, or his seat, because she was a fucking snatch.
My technically not my seat.
Yeah, you had a chair there.
I had a chair, and like nobody cares.
The funniest part was another dude came and sat in that same chair later. Bigger dude.
Oh yeah, bigger dude.
Bigger Hawaiian dude that like his company rents the seats, the benches that the teams use. The heated bench seats.
Yeah, the heated benches.
Yeah, we talked to him about it. We're like, that's kind of cool.
Hate that fucking bitch.
Yeah. So Jake got asked to leave by security because he didn't have a ticket for that seat, which was stupid because this fucking bitch's husband couldn't get by to his seat or something. I don't understand.
I asked several times for a clarification how in what way I was impeding their enjoyment of the game.
Right.
And in no way were they able to verbalize it to me.
Because she wasn't enjoying the game.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Because they weren't there to enjoy the game. And he got mad because I called him out. He's like, we paid $10,000 to be here. I'm like, and I thought he meant that he was trying to say that he was a season ticket holder. I'm like, oh, so they gave you a little license plate cover then. And he's like, oh, so you're going to be a dick too? I'm like, fucking imagine energy, dude.
Right. Yeah. I heard that part. Here's during Shout, and you'll see her in the fucking terrible beanie with the pom-pom on the top of it. That's like Bailey, everybody's,
there's Bailey. Yeah,
everybody's doing their thing, and there's her sitting there. Ray, not dun, having dun, fun
dun, dun,
during sharing. Shout. How are you going to sit there during Shout and not fucking have fun?
Right.
I sent you the video earlier of the fucking announcers even dancing to it. The Fox guys in the booth. They were fucking hyped.
Let's see.
I should see how much those tickets are and just get them for next year so we don't have any more tourists.
Well, I've been considering them myself.
It's hard. I don't know how you get those seats because I got lucky when I got them. I need to call the ticket office and ask them because nobody has had the seats next to us the last year or 2 years, this season and last season, because the year before that, the guy who had them before was bitching that he wanted my seats because how did you get those seats? And I was like, I just got them on the website. They were Dino's seats before. And he's like, oh, I know, blah, blah, blah. And he's like, well, I'd really like them. And I'm like, I bet you would. Because there's no goalpost in the way.
Yeah.
And then the ticket office contacted me. Well, he wrote this letter about how he'd like those seats, and he's donated a lot of money. And I was like, well, here's my letter, because I can also write.
Yeah.
These were Dino's seats.
And I'm not gonna. And I got some hammers behind me too, who also know how to write.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, it did not work out for that guy, and he fucking was like, well, I'm taking my money then. And the U of O was like, okay.
So here is this hoe bag. I'm just gonna play the audio because I've got the Twitter up right here. So here she is. Like, trigger warning for anybody who hates this sound.
Mm-hmm. Is it playing?
Did you not hear it?
No.
Nope.
Oh, then her screeching definitely canceled out on my microphone. Here, let me see if I can change it up. Let's see.
I can scroll back and find it, I think.
Hold the phone. I'll try that.
Tyrone. Oh, my God. I heard Boomer Sooner. You're
trying. It says captions are auto-generated. Could not transcribe the audio.
Yeah, because she's a fucking wiener.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, here's more.
Nothing.
Nothing?
Nothing.
Yeah, I happened to tweet her and I told her that
I hope she. Did you hear that?
No.
You can't hear it online either. She's no, so annoying that she's being noise canceled.
She's so shrill that our microphones will not allow her to play. That's hilarious.
I'll post a link in the
comments. Post it on the Instagram.
Okay. Oh yeah, I can send you the video directly because I saved it. Where's the
Just send it to my Twitter or my Facebook or something. Facebook.
The book of the face.
The book of the face. A book of the Beppy.
Oh God! I'm like
God.
So there was one time I was so. Jen and I,
this picture.
That's so good.
There's another one. Hold on, I gotta show you this other picture of Dave.
Is that in the Jessica's boob chat? Because I got fucking. Yeah. I got memes for that.
Where is it at?
Found it. Got it. This is great. This is great podcasting, by the way. People love listening to us talk about our phone.
Well, my favorite is like, look, Dave is talking to that guy's wife, and he's just looking over there. Like I'm taking pictures of me and my kid.
Right.
And Dave's over there hitting on some dude's wife.
He loves it though.
Oh, here it is. Look at him. Look at Dave.
Look at him. He's doing it.
They're just talking. And look, like, hey, what's going on? Look at the husband's right there. Like, yeah. And the fucking step or father-in-law is like looking over there like, Dave, what are you doing?
Like, what are you doing, Dave?
I do what I want.
Look, there's another one.
That's called evidence in some places.
That is called evidence.
Just evidence. I'm just being a nice guy, you know, chatty, like, chatty Cathy.
Chat. Just how you doing? Chatty Cathy over here.
What are you
here?
Doing after this? Yeah.
You know what'll happen though? Like, I'll be talking to her, and then we'll end the conversation. And her husband, like every time, he reaches out to high five me, grabs my arm, and pulls me in and like hugs me. And I'm like
what's going on here? Yeah. Every time, me too, and I don't get it. Yeah. I don't even talk to her that long. Like, hey, what's up? And
she's, was it this game? When I walked in, she like was grabbing you by the throat or something.
Probably.
It was, and I looked up and I was like, "Where's mine?"
Yes, it was.
And I was like, "Where's mine?"
Mm-hmm.
And she's like, "Well, you want me to?" I'm like. You're I don't like, yes, just say
please
things.
Grab me by the
like,
throat.
Yes, choke me.
Choke me, daddy. Mm-hmm. Oh my God. Yeah, that fucking bitch. Yeah.
Well, no, not that bitch, a different bitch.
No.
Yeah, I'm still like sorry, my head just Yeah.
We flip back to the bitch that we hate.
Boomer Sooner bitch.
Boomer Sooner bitch. That's and like yeah.
I
man.
Almost want to make that the title of the episode, but I hate her so much she doesn't deserve it.
Mm.
I'm about to send a funny, and I'm gonna send it to David as well.
See, here you can tell how sober Dave is because this is him.
He's just having a great time over there.
He's like,
my eyes don't get that big when I'm not sober.
And then, wait. The very next picture, right after that, you decided to yell at somebody.
Oh yeah.
That looks like that's holding Dave.
Egregious!
Holding!
I like how, too, like when arms crossed, just sitting there, but then when I decide to yell, the left hand needs to come up.
Mm-hmm.
Like it's a power scream.
So the funniest part about getting kicked out of the section is like we immediately ran up and down to the next section.
Mm-hmm.
And like, and our good friend. And her husband looks over at us, and there's Ben and me just like dancing and doing shout from the next section over. And she's like, "How did you get over there?" And I'm like, "I don't know.
We have the stadium."
Yeah, because well, I know how to get places.
That the funnier part to me was like, did we not just get somebody kicked out of that section earlier for wearing beaver gear?
yeah, they were in the aisleway.
There's like three or four beavers there. We're like, get out of here.
So, there's these three guys in beaver gear because they had a game earlier in the day and they decided to show up at ours. I don't know how they got in. Wow, people can sneak in or something. I don't know. And so I go to security in a world. I go, hey, these guys are harassing people and they don't have tickets to stand there in the aisle. And he's like, oh, they don't. And so he goes and he's like, you guys need to go. And they're like, no. And he's like, all right. And he goes and gets the cops. And then they start to run off. And he climbs up in that section and chases after him.
Mm-hmm. And then awesome. One of them, so where our seats are, and then where Jake, you guys were at, right? How there's the tunnel.
Yeah.
So one of them went up to the top and was just along the rail and tried crossing over to section 21, right behind our seats.
Oh, yeah.
And there was one, this older, bigger dude, he just kept standing there. And the guy kept walking into him. And he kept bumping him, and the guy's just like turning in circles, like just in this kid's way, like, I don't know what's going on.
What am I doing?
Yeah, like the kid's like, hey, I'm trying to, like, he's like, move over. And the guy's like, is just literally like spinning in circles in his spot. And like, ah. And I'm like, that's awesome.
Oh my goodness. Was
very awesome.
So, anyway.
What did you say? Soon. That needs to go on TikTok and or
Instagram.
Fuck, Instagrams and all that shit.
Instagrams.
Oh. Oh, when you can't find your Thanksgiving turkey, but that guy will do.
That guy would be several Thanksgiving turkeys. Like, you know, there's I thought these guys smelled bad on the outside.
Oh, this guy goes by the what does he say? The lady killer handle Wampa One.
Wampa One.
Wampa One.
Does Jay and Silent Bob are fucking clown shoes. If they were real, I would beat the shit out of them for being so stupid.
Fuck them up their stupid asses. Fuck Jay and Silent Bob. Fuck them up their stupid asses. Stupid asses. That's what he says. Mm-hmm.
Who the fuck said that shit?
I'm going to post those two videos on my Instagram right now. It's Red Arrow Deep South.
Red Arrow Deep South, where you can find all the funniest videos of terrible people being terrible.
God, she fucking sucks.
She's the worst, man. And just like throughout the entire season, we've come down there and been borderline hostile to most conference opponents, and then reasonable to all non-conference opponents. But we've had way too many people in that section every game this year. And every game this year, security comes over and is like, oh, hey guys, how's it going? Good to see you. Cool. All right. Mm-hmm. And the people who get those seats on StubHub every week go, oh, hey, you know, no one cares because their team is losing by 100. And yeah, nobody cares. And they usually leave early. But just someone who was there, they weren't there for football. They weren't there for the same reason I was there. And that's always the problem, is I always get into shit with people who aren't there for the same reason I'm there. Oh, we haven't even talked about our first run-in with CMS.
What was the first one?
Well, when your dad showed up.
Oh, yeah. I was like, what are you talking about? Before the game. Yeah
before the game.
So, yeah, as I said, my dad didn't ride up with us like normal because of the stuff going on with my mom. And so he rode his motorcycle up and he showed up late and he pulls in to park in our section. He's got the handicap sticker on his bike and goes to go in the handicap section.
Which is one of the most hilarious things I've ever seen, by the way.
Right?
A handicap sticker on a motorcycle.
They make them. It's, mm-hmm. And the funnier part is that it's a wheelchair.
Right.
Handicap sticker. Like, it's legit.
No, it's real. It's a real thing. It's just really funny.
He parks in one of the wheelchair spots right next to us. And the fucking security guys are losing their shit over him parking there. And he's like, all right, well, fine. And then on the radio, this fucking chick is like, he just bum rushed his way by. Or I don't remember how she worded it, but something along those lines. and didn't pay and blah, blah, blah. And he's like, I offered to pay. And the guy was like, just go through. Like, this is the calmest I've ever seen my dad. Like, the right. exact opposite of us when we're dealing with CMS.
At the same CMS. Moment right now. Like, there was a time, there was a moment, like, Ben comes over and he's like, is this getting out of hand? I'm like, no, yeah. it's actually quite in hand, mostly because I've stopped talking. So while I have raised the white flag and declared a personal ceasefire with CMS while your dad handles business, this fucking jerk off comes walking up from behind and says, hey, just so you guys know, you're going to have to put your tents away when the game starts.
Is that what we do?
And yeah. So it's clear, like, this guy just came over to say something about something to somebody. And he fucking picked the wrong dude, man, because he got me. And I already don't like CMS.
Right.
And so I laid into a series of fucks, motherfuckers, and stupid assholes that I'm quite proud of. Came down to essentially, like, why the fuck are you bothering us? Like, this is the first time we've ever fucking tailgated here, you hillbilly fuck. Like, get the fuck out of my face and go bother someone else, you stupid asshole. Get the fuck out of here. Like, what the fuck do you want me to do? Like, we're currently using the tent. Go away. Oh, I'm just saying. Like, you're not saying shit. Go the fuck away. Fuck right. you, motherfucker.
You know what he said after that?
Nothing. Not shit.
He fucking turned around and left.
Yep. Should have followed him and then pointed at every tent. Hey, did you let them know? Did you let them know?
I made my point. All fucking
5,000 tents that are up here. Did you let them know?
All I said was, yeah, because I always leave my stuff out so it can get stolen. Shut up.
And I was in docile aggressive mode and then got reactivated. So he could have let me calm down. He could have let me chill. I was on my way down. I was working through it. I was box breathing. Mm-hmm. I was being mindful of the moment. And then this guy comes over here. Like, I've been drinking green tea all goddamn day. He's going to bring out the demons in me.
Pokes the bear from the other side.
For real. Like, what are you doing? Like, can't you see that I'm over here actively disengaging from the aggression, man?
Could not. He could not see that. So that was a lot of fun and awesome thing this week. Basically, my dad, I was like, he's just gonna park next to my car in our spot that there's no one else gonna be in. It's fine. And he's like, all right, well, he's gotta pay. And I was like, he already told you he was gonna pay.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not talking anymore, and I just stopped.
I was like, I'm going.
I can only say the same thing so many times. That's why I hate repeating myself when I teach. I'm like, hear it the first time, understand it the first time, and we won't have a problem.
Increase your listening comprehension.
Anyway, game went on. That fucking bitch yelled at Lincoln Riley again. You'll see the second video on Instagram, too. I'll post that now. And she yells, what did he, she yells, like, Boomer Sooner or something.
Like, Oklahoma's better without you. Fuck you, motherfucker.
Here, I'll play it so I can listen. Boomer Sooner, you traitor. And he goes, you too, sweetheart.
I didn't hear that part.
Yeah. He goes, that's you funny. Too, sweetheart. Ding. Mm-hmm.
Was
you can't hear it there.
Yeah. Was Lincoln Riley the what coach just kicked a kid off the team for taking 2 weeks off for a mental health break? Was that Lincoln Riley?
That's a good question. Jamie, look that up.
Yep, I'm looking it up right now. did you guys hear about that?
I did not.
All right. You heard about this?
So Dave's looking that up. Yeah, man, like, here's something that I've learned is, like, when you go someplace, you kind of have to become one with the culture that's in that place. And fuck you, hobag.
I just, like, if you go back and watch that video, maybe I should post that too, where everybody's like, hey, and she's not doing anything. Like, literally, what is wrong with you? Why would you come to something you're going to hate so much?
Some people are so driven by negativity. It's actually really sad.
It's what kept Darth Maul alive.
Until he got cut in half.
No, after he got cut in half.
Oh, I didn't know he's. I know about that.
During the cartoons, he survives.
Yep.
He goes like spider legs for a while. Like, he goes metal legs like fucking Star Fox.
Yeah, kind of.
Yep.
Because didn't he? The Han Solo scene that he's in is after he was cut in half, right? The Solo movie. Yeah.
So it goes. He cut in half.
Mm-hmm.
And then the cartoons come out, and there's a part where he's got like spider legs, metal like robot spider legs. And then he gets regular walking legs.
And then he gets baby movie. Legs.
And he gets baby legs.
Look at him, he's shirt cocked.
And it looks so big in this baby hand. But yeah,
hey, baby legs, Maul. You got to learn how to work with the Sith, and regular legs, Darth. You got to work together.
Yeah. If you're a Sith, you don't have your own legs.
Nope, that's not how it works.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so this coach, not Lincoln Riley, Lane Kiffin, Ole Miss's head coach.
Yeah. So, oh, Lane Kiffin did it?
Yeah, Lane Kiffin did it. So basically, it was the kid leaked the audio after he got kicked off the team, I think.
Yeah.
And it's basically Lane Kiffin being like, hey, you can't take 2 weeks off. And the kid's like, well, you know, I was having like mental health problems, you know, and I wanted to take some mental health days. He's like, 2 weeks? He's like, we called you. We've been trying to get a hold of you, trying to be like, hey, like, come on in. Like, let's get you some help and blah, blah, blah. And he's like, you just disappeared for 2 weeks. And he kicks him off the team. So now Lane Kiffin's in trouble. And there's a whole lot of back and forth because it's like, yeah, the kid was going through some stuff. Completely understandable.
Yeah.
But he's a scholarship athlete and just gave up on, didn't go to classes, didn't tell anybody.
I'm on Lane Kiffin's side on this.
Yeah, exactly. Again, we've all been through tough spots and mental health issues. Take care of it, but don't just like skip out on all your responsibilities.
You can't completely check out. You have to at least tell somebody what's going on and then especially, go talk to somebody.
Especially when you hear on the chat that he's saying like, look, like we tried to get a hold of you for 2 weeks, like reaching out to you, trying to get you to come in and get help. Like you don't get to turn the doctor down when you're saying that you're having a mental health crisis. That's not how it works.
Yeah. So it's like, it's one of those things that's going back and forth right now where people are picking sides. And the first thing when I heard it, I was like, I listened to part of the audio. I'm like, yeah, he's telling the kid that like he had chances.
Yeah.
Like, that's on you, bud.
You don't just get kicked off the team.
Not generally, no.
No.
You have to do something.
Mm-hmm.
You earn your way off. Just like you earn your way on.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I called out one of my coworkers the other day for using the phrase promoted to customer, which I hate it so much.
I've never heard that.
Yeah. I said, and he's like, yeah, you know, he'll probably end up getting promoted to customer. I'm like, please, please don't say that around me. That's so dumb. He's like, what do you mean? I'm like, don't you understand what the inference of that phrase means? It means that any position outside this company is better than any position within it, including yours.
Mm-hmm.
A promotion to customer means an improvement in lifestyle. So by telling me that you're promoting someone to customer means that this job is not worth doing.
Yeah.
So you need to change your phraseology. He's like, well, I just, I'm like, no, I don't need a, well, I just, I'm just, I, well, I just told you.
Mm-hmm. Well, I had a moment like that at the tailgate too. Those guys that were there, the guys that were at the tailgate.
Yeah,
I can't remember. Kyle and his buddy.
Yeah.
Well, his buddy's kid is in the Navy apparently, and we were talking, and he found out I'm Filipino, and he says to me, he's like, "Oh, your mom Filipino?" He's like, "Yeah." I was like, "Yeah." He's like, "Oh, she's not like a mail order bride or anything." I'm like, "You don't know me well enough to be making jokes like that, so I'm gonna let this one slide." And he was just like, "Oh," I was like, "Yeah."
I caught the corner, like,
yeah,
a bit of that, and I was like. Mm-hmm.
I was like, you just met me, and so I'm gonna let this slide, but you don't know me well enough to be making jokes like that. All right.
Like, I do know you well enough to make jokes like that, and I won't make
jokes.
Yeah,
like,
I'm still not making that joke.
I was like, I've had friends, you know, I've had lifelong friends that have maybe said something once. And I was like, you don't know me.
I don't know that it's funny even.
Yeah.
It's like if
he said it and it was something that was funny, you could be like, okay, look, man.
Yeah. Right.
But yeah, like that's
like, you don't know me.
Don't know me, don't bro me.
Yeah.
A good one.
I like it.
That, so we're up top, like right at the beginning of the game, and it's Veterans Day, so they're doing the salute to service and all that. And you know, I'm there with Ben, who's in the Army Reserves. And so when they say, you know, give a round of applause for all the active service people in the area, like Bailey and I start gassing up Ben because that's what we're here for. We're not in the military, but he is. So cheer for him. That's our dude. His success is our success. That whole deal. Mm-hmm. And so this fucking guy in a USC shirt and a blue jacket standing next to us, it was like, hey, I'm like, what? He's like, I was in the Navy for, I'm like, what? Like, I'm celebrating my brother. He's like, I was in the Navy for 8 years. I was like, okay, and now you're a civilian.
Yeah, I don't know you. I don't care.
Yeah.
Can more than one person be in the military? Yeah. We don't know you. Fuck off.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, you were in the Navy. He's in the Army, so it's okay. But like the guy who's next to us, he's like, oh, you're in the, and they like get the whole handshake and everything that older veterans do to younger veterans, right?
Yeah.
And so, but then this other guy, he's like, oh, I was in the Army, Navy. I'm like, are you upset that people care about him and not about you? Is that what's happening right now? You can fuck off too. Like,
he's the guy that unironically posts the "You're welcome for my service" memes.
Oh, right.
You know, because I actually missed out on it. I didn't do it again this year, which I usually do. But we all know that I am ironically doing it. I don't.
Yeah.
Right.
Like every time, like you guys have been places with me where they're like veteran stand up, and I don't do it because I'm not looking for that.
Right.
You know,
I think you should.
I know. Yeah. I do sometimes. Sometimes I'm just like, I'm not, you know, like.
Sometimes you don't feel like it.
Yeah, I don't feel like it.
And that's your right to not, but yeah. I still think you should.
Mm-hmm. But you know what I mean? It's like, there's those guys that are out there being like, hey, did you know that I was in the military?
There are the guys who wear the Purple Heart leather jackets. That's all there is. That's all you need to say.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I hope I see one of those one day, because I don't think I have.
Go to a gun show.
Oh. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That makes sense.
Yeah, like I've been to enough gun shows in my life that I've seen so many fucking
got tickets.
That's only one gun over there though.
Oh,
Oh actually I might be working some gun shows this summer.
That's funny, Dave. Like, I forget that you work at a gun store. Like, I can't wait to hear like the types of people that come through the door.
We're gonna have some good stories.
Oh, I was going to say, one of the weirdest things that happened to me in a gun store is I was hanging out with my dad. We're looking at guns. Weird thing. And this guy's phone goes off, and it's a gun going off and a shell casing hitting the ground. And I've never heard a store go quiet faster. Like, everyone turns and looks at this guy. He's like, yeah, I should probably change that, huh? I didn't think about I hadn't thought about it. Like that, like he's just standing there, and everybody's like, you see, there's like eight dudes ready to stand their ground,
right?
Like,
they're ready. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Well, that's the one thing they're at work they're talking about. It was like my third day, and I was talking to one of the guys that had been there for a while. He's like, oh, yeah, and like you can carry at work. And I was like, I can carry at every job. I was like, yes. Yep. He kind of chuckled. He's like, all right, I just want, like, I was like, no, I get it. You're just like putting it up, like making sure if I didn't know for sure. I was like, but I can carry at every job.
Yeah, I get to do things a lot of people don't.
Yeah.
But speaking of
concealed.
I was talking to Ben, and you know, he missed out on his first free IHOP. And he was like, oh man, you know, miss out. I'm like, it's okay, dude. You're going to have, you have a lot of Veterans Days ahead of you.
Mm-hmm.
He's like, what do you mean? I only have like three. Like, what are you talking about? You're a veteran for the rest of your life. He's like, Yeah. This complete realization. Mm-hmm. I'm like, yeah, you get free food once it's a day every year. Yeah, it's your double birthday, man. Like, mm-hmm. way to go. Good job. You unlocked the cheat code to free food mm-hmm. once one day.
And certain restaurants. I've told you guys the accidental drunken Vegas story before, haven't I?
Tell it again for the archives. Yes.
I was in Vegas for my sister's 30th birthday. It was I was stationed in San Diego, so it was a short trip. I was only there for 2 days. So the day we were supposed to leave, my wife and I, we go to the Toby Keith's I Love This Bar and Grill. And we order a bucket of beer. And then the lady looks at me and I'm clean shaven, haircut. And she says, oh, are you in the military? I'm like, yeah, active duty. And I showed her my ID. And she's like, oh, you get a free beer and a burger. And I was like, oh, cool.
Hell yeah.
I'm thinking a free beer. Here's a bottle of Miller Lite or something like that. So we go ahead and order that bucket of beer. And my wife ordered another drink for her. They come out with a 32-ounce mason jar and a burger.
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh, okay. So I've got this bucket of beer. It's got five or six beers in it, bottles of beer in it, this 32-ouncer. And I'm like, well, I guess I'm drinking. So I'm drinking
these.
That math
doesn't math. This must be really small beers. This must be really small beers to get five beers into a 32-ounce
glass. No. It was a 32-ounce glass of beer and a bucket of beer.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I'm with you now. Okay.
Yeah. So because, like I said, when they said you get a free beer, I'm thinking a bottle of beer. So I'm like, okay, cool. I'm going to drink six beers.
Over 100 ounces of beer.
Yes. And I'm like, oh, okay. So I drink them. I eat my burger and we get up to leave. And we're walking down the strip and I'm like, babe, we can't like go anywhere yet. She's like, okay, no, that's fair. So we're walking and this is, way pre-COVID. So they're still selling drinks right on the sidewalk. And we're like, ooh, a margarita slushy. That sounds great. Get one of those, start drinking it. It's like 100 degrees out. Like, better get another drink. It's really hot out here. Next thing you know, the sun's starting getting down mm-hmm. and it's like, oh,
sun's getting real low.
Sun's getting real low, big guy. And we still have to drive back to San Diego. So my wife stops drinking.
Wagging it, smacking it, wagging a jack.
We get in the car, and I'm in a suit. I'm in a suit because I only took nice clothes because we went out to some really fancy places for my sister's birthday. So we drive all the way back to San Diego. I sleep some of the way. We don't even stop at the house. She drives me straight to the ship. And I get out, unbuttoned dress shirt, wrinkled up suit. And I just go up on, I'm like, permission to come aboard. And they're like, what the fuck are you been doing? I was like, I just got back from Vegas. They're like just got back from Vegas. I'm like, just got back from Vegas. And I'm supposed to go do turnover. Basically, I'm supposed to do ammo and weapon stuff. And I'm like, I'm going to go down to the armory and sleep.
Well, if you knew anything about Toby Keith, is that the reason they brought you that much beer is that we'll raise up our glasses against evil forces, whiskey for my men and beer for my horses. So they brought you enough beer for a horse.
Beer for a horse.
Yeah. Horse-sized beer.
Mm-hmm. The old horse beer.
The old horse beer.
Oh, man.
Have this beer and horse it.
Wait. No.
My first night ever in Vegas started in that same bar. Like that mm-hmm. was, we went there because my buddy that I was in band in high school, his band was playing there. And he's like, hey guys, get some drinks. They're on me. I'm like, sure. Okay. Are. And he's like, afterwards, we're going to go down to this other bar. And guess what? Drinks are on me.
Sure are.
We got fucking hammered. Till 6 in the morning. I remember sitting at this other bar.
That's 6 a.m. That's not 6 in the morning. That's 6 a.m.
6 a.m. I'm talking to these people, and this chick won't leave me alone. She's some old fucking cougar with, like, cougar. And I just, like, went into a Russian accent and would not break character.
I cannot.
Would not break character.
I cannot.
Like, the whole time.
That's awesome.
Respect the kayfabe.
Right? It was a good time.
I had this group of girls come up to me this same trip for my sister's birthday. And this one girl comes up to me. She says, hey, you're pretty cute. I'm like, well, thanks. And she's like, I'm trying to get married in one of those Vegas, like the Vegas marriage things. And I was like, that's cool. She's like, do you want to get married? And I was like, I'm already.
Not really.
Yeah. I was like, I already did that once. Because my wife was at a slot machine, like, you know, maybe 10 feet away.
Mm-hmm.
And she's like, come on, it's just for fun. I was like, I don't think that would be fun for me.
But that's not how I have fun.
Yeah.
Not great fun.
And then my wife comes up and the girl was trying to convince her to let me marry her.
Like, come on.
With Elvis Presley thing. I was just like, I feel like I'm going to get in trouble. And I didn't even do anything.
I've told Jen, like, we're going to go back and get the whole real deal, schmacking a meal. Like, Eddie's going to do our wedding and everything.
Yeah. You miss Eddie.
Yeah. Yeah. We want to do the whole tacky thing. You know, we did the sweet backyard wedding. Now we want to go be fucking go to the pawn shop, buy a rock, you know,
get the buffet brunch.
Exactly.
Yeah. That's where it's at. The American dream.
That's the American dream all the way through.
Shit.
God, I kind of want to go to Vegas now.
I was actually thinking, like, the three of us, we should go to Vegas.
We were supposed to be in Vegas this weekend. Remember that? Well,
yeah, I do remember that.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Brian. He's not listening, so
yeah.
I know he's...
Well, yeah, he does. He never does.
I mean, I would still talk shit to him anyway, but, yeah.
Say it again?
I said you guys were supposed to be there. I was going to be too broke.
Well, I was going to go whether I was broke or not.
Just, yeah, I was gonna find a way. I would sell a kidney or something.
Yeah, you have two of them.
A kid and a knee.
Yeah,
it's weird.
Yeah. I got two kids and I got two knees. Like I can, and if I only have one knee, then I get to be on fucking handicap on.
Or
everything.
You could have sold one of the knees from one of the kids, and then it's a kid knee.
Or a kid's knee. Yeah.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I don't know the math on that, but sounds like
if you sold
work.
A kid's kidney and his knee, you'd have a kid kidney knee.
Kid kidney knee.
Mm-hmm. That's like a pin pineapple pineapple.
I don't know what just happened.
Pineapple pen.
Kid, pen I have a pen. I have an apple.
Apple pen.
Apple pen.
That's some Asian comedy right there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I wanted to dress up as that guy for 1 year for Halloween, but then
but
I
nobody
ended up
would
not doing
get
anything.
It.
Yeah, and then I ended up not doing anything for Halloween. Maybe
you
I'll just
been
do
Psy.
That.
Hey,
Dave, you should be Psy for Halloween.
Mm-hmm. I'd have to shave then.
Yeah, it'd be funny though. I shaved for Halloween. Is this worth it? I remember that.
Oh yeah, you were there. Cause yeah. Were you not Jake from State Farm?
No, I was after sex.
Oh,
Ron
Swanson. Burgundy. Yeah, Ron Swanson, not Ron Burgundy. Yeah. That's right.
I had a date the day after that too, and I like had to explain to the girl. I was like, okay, listen. I'm about to show up to this date with a full-on mustache. I want you to understand that I do not normally have a mustache. And, yeah, she played rugby for OSU and...
All right.
Scored a try.
One time, Robin and I went to the casino and I dressed up as a hipster Santa Claus.
That's awesome.
do you remember that?
I do.
Also, if you want chicks to sit on your lap during Halloween,
mm-hmm.
dress up as Santa Claus.
I just wore a green, the green captain hat and a green polo. And I was like, mm-hmm. I'm just the captain.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it was
I had
times.
Like some red corduroy pants.
Dress as
some red suspender.
He's taking yes. notes.
Santa Claus, Halloween Santa Claus. They all want to sit on your lap and tell you how good
Ooh,
a girl
Halloween
they've been.
Santa Claus would be a good name.
Halloween Santa Claus might be the name of this episode.
Mm-hmm. I like Harlow and Garlow still.
Harlow and Garlow is pretty good.
Harlow and Garlow is solid. Oh, shit.
Damn it. And now I'm definitely dressing up as Santa Claus next Halloween again.
There you go. So we got an away game this week. Game's at 1.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, at least it's at 1.
Yeah.
Gets it over with.
Sit around and wait all day.
Right.
I just watch one game. It's an amuse bouche for the duck game. then we watch the game. Then afterwards we get to watch a nice game as a come down, and then methadone football on Sunday.
It's on Fox.
Methadone football would also be a good name.
Jake, I might call you on Saturday.
What are you gonna call me?
Jake.
From State Farm. All right. I need to put Fox on my phone to watch the game. Because I'll be at work.
Ah. I told Riv right around Halloween that you were Jake from State Farm at one point. Mm-hmm. And she goes, isn't he black? And I go, black yeah, adjacent. And? She's like, oh.
Not the original.
Sure he is there.
Not the original.
Yeah, exactly. The
original Jake from State Farm. OG Jake from State Farm. Mm-hmm. Before they ditched him and got a good-looking, light-skinned dude. That's what they did.
They sure did. That is exactly what they did.
It's insurance Devin Booker is what it is.
Insurance. No, Devin Booker's got those beady little eyes you can't fucking trust.
Oh, yeah. It's insurance Drake.
There we go. That was. Do you remember when Drake was on? He showed up for that one episode. That one episode of the commercial.
The episode of the commercials. Yes.
I had a really good idea for a marketing campaign for Allstate. It should be Allstate. It'd be the college football's official insurance provider, and everything would be Allstate. And you get all these throwback athletes and stuff. Basically, just build on the Heisman House concept.
There you go.
But you know, we are Allstate.
Yeah. I feel like Robin needs to dress up as an insurance guy, because out of the three of us, he's the only one that hasn't been an insurance guy.
I haven't been an insurance guy.
You were Jake from State Farm.
No, I wasn't.
He just is Jake from State Farm.
Oh, I thought
people call me that. I was Ron Swanson after sex.
Right.
Yeah, that's right.
It just looked like Jake from State Farm.
But I had the mustache.
But the mustache,
yep. Yeah,
was the touch.
Okay.
And the hair, I had a comb over.
Oh, remember a couple weeks ago we were asking about how long you've been saying put your dick away?
Yeah.
I watched the video from when I dressed up as you for Halloween, which was like 9 years ago.
Okay.
And I said it. As you walked in, I said, hey, put your dick away.
Yeah.
So it's been around since before that.
It's like a decade of putting your dick away.
At least, because it would have to be established that you say it.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's like me saying yeah, well,
yeah,
or well, hey.
We should make that a T-shirt.
Well, hey,
put your dick away.
Hey, put your dick away. 10 years running.
10 years running.
No, it's just the door creaking open with a hand like in it or something.
A decade of dick away.
Hashtag decade of dick away.
Hey, put your dick away.
Oh, a face search.
You know, these people, they're going to be anywhere in the world, but they put their dick away. We appreciate that. Make sure you're checking out the YouTube if you want the full meal deal. You want the whole pre-show where we talk about what we're talking about. And we're a little bit loosey-goosey there during the pre-show. If that's your style of show, check us out there on YouTube. Elsewise, you can find us on the Spotify and always badfacts.info. Shut up, Dave. But for this episode, this edition, good night, universe.
That's a podcast.
Good ducks.
Go ducks.